I'm the magical sunlight water nutrients fairy. I'm going to sprinkle sunlight water nutrients all over the forest floor. We're going to let you use your branches, okay? You're going to just use your hands to gather up as much sunlight water and nutrients as you can until I say stop. Ready? One, two, three, go. I'm here to teach the kids basically about trees, how they grow. We're going to be looking at tree cookies, which are basically the cross section of a tree. So you can count the rings, see how old they are, see how much growth they have, kind of look at the story of the tree. You can kind of tell what happened to that tree over its life by looking at the tree rings. Go over what trees need to grow and how foresters like myself kind of try to use those things to manipulate the forest to be what we want, healthy and growing the different species and the different forms of trees that we want. And then we're going to play a little game where all the kids get to be a tree out in the woods competing for sunlight, water, nutrients. And based on what species they are and how much sunlight, water, nutrients they get, that determines whether they're a saw log or whether they're pulpwood or whether they're, you know, a snag, a tree that died. And then we kind of show what a forester would do with that stand of trees that we've grown now, so the kids kind of have an idea of what a professional forester does.
There are a lot of really good bugs, but some bugs we don't think are so good as humans. Mosquitoes we don't really like too much. And I want to talk about a bug that we don't like because they kill trees. This particular bug or insect is called the Asian longhorn beetle. And the reason we don't like these insects is because they kill hardwood trees like maples, and maple trees we really like because who likes maple syrup? Yeah, we have not had this bug in Maine, but we're really worried about it coming to Maine because we're worried about it killing our maple trees and our birch trees and our beech trees. What we want you guys to do is keep your eyes open for these adults in the summer and in the early fall. And if you find them, to call us and tell us.
The birch is the tree with the paper bark on it. In all my teaching, especially with people about who don't know much about the forest, one of the aspects that they enjoy the most is learning about the different species. It's like learning a language. Now you can go out in the forest and actually recognize what are the different trees there. Divide those into two similar groups. But yeah, you get one that's different from all the others. What's the difference? Longer needles. These are the pine trees. Pine trees are the ones with the long needles. Now look at how many needles are grouped together. If you look at it, do you see them? Are they single or are they in clusters?
Clusters.
Five. It's actually, you may see some with four, but actually when they grow out first, they have five. But once you start recognizing what's there, then you begin to see, oh, the pines are the tallest trees. Or you only see the birch where it's been open, or you only see sugar maple growing in the shade. So once they begin to know what the different species are, start learning the language out there, then they'll begin to understand much better what the forest is about.
Most foresters in Maine, if they're up in northern Maine, they work for a big industrial landowner. They may own like a million acres of forest land, okay? And they help that landowner manage their forest. Down here, where we don't have big industrial holdings, we have more small landowners where people may own 10 or 20 or 100 acres at a time. There's more consulting foresters where they have lots of different clients and they help all those different clients make decisions and manage their forest land for whatever the landowners want. All right, ready? One, two, three, stop. Everybody stand up. All right, so you gotta, if you drop them, you can't pick them up. You gotta divide it out into three piles in your hands or your pockets and count out how many you have of each one. It is hard. Trees have a hard life out there in the woods. This is not easy business. 15 water, my goodness, you were thirsty. What do you guys notice about her? She's out on the edge, right? You think there's more competition or less competition over where she is? It was probably easier for her to gather some stuff up because she was on the edge. You became a saw log. If you look on the back, it kind of tells the story. This is just what we could be using you for if we decided to cut you down. Doesn't mean we're going to cut you down. Depending on what our landowner wanted, like if our landowner wanted firewood, we could thin out some of the firewood. Or if they wanted some money, we might have to cut down some of the saw logs. They want wildlife habitat, so we're going to keep the snag. And once we thin you guys out, you think you'd be able to get more sunlight, water, nutrients? More. All right. Thanks, guys.
Bye.